Hello everyone. Under normal circumstances, this would be winter graduation week at the University of Aberdeen. We'd all be wearing our gowns and caps, and you'd be walking across the stage for me to doff you on the head to mark the fact that this is your graduation day, with huge cheers from your family and friends. Of course, under the current circumstances, it's not possible to have our graduation ceremonies in the normal way, but it's still absolutely a time to celebrate. In fact, your achievement is especially remarkable this year, because it's been done under extraordinary circumstances. All our students have shown amazing resilience and perseverance, despite these difficulties, to achieve outstanding academic success. So today I'm delighted to congratulate you on that success. We here at Aberdeen are very proud of what you've achieved. We're still planning to have proper traditional graduation ceremonies when the circumstances allow. So we hope to see you with your friends and family so that in due course, we can all celebrate together. About to see the world in action. What we can be, life with no distractions. We'll get away, this is what we waited for.
Dear graduands, may I be among the first to congratulate you on your terrific achievement. Graduation represents the culmination of months and years of hard work on your part. You have endured countless hours of lectures and seminars, long days in the library, the stressful deadlines and assignments, particularly with the challenges that 2020 has brought with it. Copious cups of coffee and occasionally maybe something a bit stronger. Now you have made it. The latest welcome addition to the role of graduates from this 525-year-old institution. Well done, each and every one of you, the class of 2020. With many of you bidding farewell to this institution and to this city, what message might go with you as you take your next step? Here, if I may, I would like to indulge in telling you about an ancient Persian story that is often back on my mind. It's about a father and his young son that went on a journey between two cities. They had one donkey, so father asked his son to ride the donkey and he walked along with him. Shortly they came across other travelers and he overheard them commenting disapprovingly on why would a young man ride whilst an older gentleman is walking. On hearing this, they decide to swap places until another group of travelers passed them. This time, others frown upon the fact that he was riding and his child had to walk in the heat of the desert. So they decide to both ride the donkey. Again, the next group of travelers passing by are aghast to observe such a cruelty inflicted on the poor animal. Fed up with the constant negativity, they decide that enough was enough and they both walked until the next group passed by. And yes, everyone thought, what a pair of idiots. They have a donkey and none of them are riding it. The moral of the story is that in life, and particularly in this day and age, with strong influences by social media on our lives, every aspect of our lives indeed, no matter what you decide to do and however you want to decide to do something, there is going to be disapproving voices. Also, those who are least equipped to analyze the situation often are more vocal critics, expressing their dismay and what you should really be doing instead. As psychology graduates, your teachers and mentors have been helping you to develop and expand your critical thinking, analyzing data and evidence-based decision-making. You are certainly well-equipped to venture forth, not only with the knowledge and understanding that you have gained from your studies, but also with new skills and confidence. You have nothing to fear in what lies ahead, and bear in mind that just like the father and son, you will never please everyone. You are well equipped to work wonders in your chosen field and change the world to be a better place for others. I wish you all happiness as you go about it.
Hello. Welcome to the School of Psychology Winter Graduation 2020. I wish we could meet in person and I wish I could welcome you to Aberdeen, but unfortunately, we can't do that at the moment. So, welcome to our virtual graduation. I'm recording this from home, and normally I would have some assistance in helping read out the names and advice on how to pronounce the names of our international students. I apologise now in advance for all the mispronunciations I am going to make. However, we do still want to provide this for you to celebrate what you've achieved this year. So, welcome to the graduation. We'll begin with students graduating with a Master of Arts Honours in Psychology. Eva Victoria Lushak. Students graduating with a Master's of Research in Psychology. Felicia Borgland with distinction. Letitia Caruso with distinction. Roisin Harrison with distinction. Matthew Johnson with distinction. Stamen Marinkoff with distinction. Ethan McDonald with distinction. James Price with distinction. Vilma Pullinen with distinction. Lena Sass with distinction. Najik Sadler with distinction. Students graduating with a Master of Science in Foundations of Clinical Psychology are Megan Al-Nadaf with distinction. Imani Almodovar with commendation. Ava Bizaz with distinction. Liana Blair with commendation. Rahul Shure. Camille Kishon with distinction. Yosanna Faber with distinction. Rachel Ferguson with distinction. Malvina Philipchuk with distinction. Tegan Fraser with distinction. Evangelos Kalanidis with distinction. Michael Kashina with distinction. Bartolomash Komen with distinction. Katerina Kunari with distinction. Sarah Langrudi with distinction. Megan Teresa Mary Law with commendation. Alexandra Manol with commendation. Carla McEnoy with distinction. Hazel McLaren with distinction. Saida Mahudin with commendation. Zineb Utabont with commendation. Ailey Quigg with distinction. Jessica Ritchie with distinction. Wendy Wallace with commendation. We now turn to our students graduating with a Master of Science in Psychological Studies. Erkenwald Apuri with distinction. Lucy Bamforth with distinction. Pauline Brindley with commendation. Zinbai Kai with commendation. Sayun Feng with commendation. Felicitas Fisher with distinction. Ashley Gior with commendation. Zaida Gu with commendation. Jinchai Gu. Emma Hardy with commendation. Nan Huang with commendation. Haiyu Jin with distinction. Zunlei Li with commendation. Yi Lu with commendation. Kirsty Luna with commendation. Roxana Marcus with distinction. Matthew Marson with commendation, Shauna McAvoy with commendation, Kirsty McLeod with commendation, Harida Maufai with commendation, Wei Neo with commendation, Chi Nguyen with commendation, Georgia Papachristopoulou with commendation, Max Reynolds with distinction, Marta Riva with distinction, Paulina Sadowska with commendation, Stuart Thompson with distinction, Yu Tian with commendation, Anupri Vyas with distinction, Dwayne Wang with distinction, Wenye Wu with commendation, and Guzhai Zhang. I'd like to congratulate students Hanu Zhang with commendation, Zhao Nun Seng with commendation, and Ziran Zhao. Finally, to all of you, I would just like to say sincerely well done. All of you have graduated in your various courses under very difficult conditions. No one expected what happened during last year and over the summer, and yet all of you managed to pull yourself together, to be resilient, to continue on your studies and complete your coursework and exams. And I think we're all incredibly proud of you that you managed to do that, and to do that so well and gain such good qualifications. So congratulations, well done. We're proud of you, and I hope you're proud of yourself as well. And I just wish you luck in the future. I know that after what you have done here at Aberdeen, that you're going to go on to great things. So good luck with your future studies, with your future careers, and take care of yourself. Thank you for listening. Goodbye.